So here's what I would have done with this problem. X plus 4, x minus 7, x plus 6, plus 3 divided by negative x minus 7, x plus 4, x minus 7, x plus 6, minus 3 over x minus 7. Positive over negative is negative, and this will not change the negative, so it becomes negative. I'm sorry? Then I will write two restrictions, not 7 and not negative 6. Then I will find the least common denominator as x minus 7, x plus 6. This does not need anything, but this one does, an x plus 6. Yes?
So the product of the usual thing can change the additions or subtraction based on?
Positive divided by negative is negative.
So it changes that sum.
If it were negative, I would have kept it positive. But if positive over negative is negative. So then I have x plus 4 minus 3x minus 18. So the simplified form for now is negative 2x plus 14 divided by x minus 7 and x plus 6. Negative 2x minus, I made a mistake. Negative 2x minus 14. Actually, I bought myself a new whiteout. I don't know if it works. We'll see in a moment. It does. Neat. Okay, so then I will factor out negative 2 and x plus 7 over x minus 7 and x plus 6. And this is the correct final simplified form. If you did not get this, did you get your mistake? If you got this, wonderful. Are we ready to move on? Or not yet? Any questions on this? Yeah. Yes. Move on to H. Yes. Any questions on this, or are we okay?
So when you
this is not a number. You mean do this expression?
Yeah.
X minus 7 multiplied by what is x minus 7 times x plus 6? This is here. It was multiplied by this. So then the numerator has to be multiplied by the same quantity. Is that somewhat better? Okay, so let's look at H. 2x plus 9 divided by 3 minus x plus x plus 5 over x plus 7 minus 2x squared plus 3x minus 3. Everything over x squared plus 4x minus 21. Say it again. Yes, the first one has to be changed. So 2x plus 9 over negative x minus 3 plus x plus 5 over x plus 7 minus 2x squared plus 3x minus 3 over, how do I factor the denominator? X plus 7 times. Good. So then you will give me two restrictions to write. Which restriction will you give me? Very good. Perfect. Now, next step. So this is positive. Careful. This is positive. This is negative. What happens now? Now let's stop for a moment and see if you have any questions. Any questions here? Brielle, go ahead, please.
I said that x minus 3 is
Right, so this was 3 minus x. I had to change it into negative x plus 3. And then I had to factor out negative 1. Since the numerator has a plus in front and the denominator has a minus, the whole fraction becomes negative. It's, imagine, 4 divided by negative 3. That will be negative 3/4. Good, only now I'm ready to find the LCD. Please tell me the LCD. Good. The adjustment, I call these the adjustment. The adjustment for the top of the first fraction. Thank you very much. Exactly what it does not have. Perfect. The adjustment for the top of the second fraction. Of course, what it does not have. The adjustment for the last one. Exactly. In other words, I don't have to worry about it.
So we have to factor
them. We never factor numerators when we add and subtract fractions. Never even look at numerators till the very last step. When you are done and you have only one fraction with one top and one bottom, then you have to factor the numerator if it's factorable. Okay? Good. Now, I don't want you to get confused. When we multiply and divide, we never determine what? The least common denominator. When we add and when we multiply and divide fractions, we never even talked about least common denominator, right? All we did was factored everything and we simplified. But now when we add and subtract fractions or rational expressions with unlike denominators, that's the first step. We have to find the least common denominator. Okay, very good. Now, I have to be super careful. Please follow me. Let's do this together, please. 2x times x with minus in front. 2x times 7 with minus in front.
-14.
Perfect. 9 times x with minus in front.
-7.
And 9 times 7 with minus in front. We only finished this. We didn't get to this. I mean, we just got to this. We didn't do anything else. We just finished with this. Now, plus x times x, x squared, x times negative 3, negative 3x, plus 5 times x, 5x, and negative 15. And you know me, I always run out of room, so I did already. So now, negative sign in front must be distributed to all terms and in the numerator. So, minus 2x squared minus 3x and plus 3. After we finish this problem, I will show you something that I'm trying at all costs to avoid. But if you understand it, you can use it. Yes?
I thought the problem was negative 2x squared plus 3x minus 3x.
So, negative 1 times 2x squared, negative 1 times 3x, negative 1 times negative 3. Good. Okay, so, what next? Of course, yes. So, I have negative 2x squared, I have positive x squared, and I have negative 2x squared. So, that's negative 4 plus 1, negative 3x squared. Then I have negative 14, negative 9, negative 3x, positive 5x, and negative 3x. This is what I would like. This is negative 6, but plus 5x is negative 1. Negative 1 with minus 9 is negative 10, so negative 24. And now the free term. This, this, and this. So 63 and 15 is 78, right? 78 minus 3, it's 75. Yes.
Negative
2x squared with negative 2x squared is negative 4x squared plus another x squared is negative 3x squared.
Oh.
They are the circled ones in red. And then x minus 3 and x plus 7. And yes, I will factor out a negative 3, of course. and get x squared plus 8x and plus 25, which is not factorable any further, x squared plus 8x plus 25. And this is it. And assuming those conditions, like 3 pages before, are part of the answer. It is a lot of work. Now, I want to show you something. And if somebody teaches you this method and you understand it or you want to use it, I'm fine with it. I avoid it at all costs, and I'll show you why. We have them right here.
So you wouldn't simplify the x plus 8x, or x squared plus 8x plus 25.
It's not factorable. How will you? But 5 times 3 is 25?
Oh, no.
No. So it's not factorable. But if it were, yes, I would have, definitely. Yes, I have to at the very last step. I have to. We did that several times in which we simplified at the end. But it's not factorable. Okay? So here is an intermediate step in this at this step here. An intermediate step. I would like to show it to you. I don't recommend it, and I'll show you why I don't recommend it. It's legitimate, but I don't recommend it. I want you to, if you look in the book. So, negative 2x plus 9 times x plus 7 plus x minus 3 times x plus 5 minus 2x squared plus 3x minus 3. Everything divided by x minus 3 times x plus 7. This is exactly what we did, but I didn't show it like that, right? X times 2x with minus in front, x times 9 with minus in front, 7 times 2x with minus in front, 7 times 9 with minus in front. Then x times x, x squared, and then 3, negative 3x, and then positive 5x, and then negative 15, and then minus 2x squared minus 3x plus 3. The reason why I refuse to write this is because it's very tempting, and some of my students follow this step with doing this. What is wrong with this? You cannot simplify because this is not a factor at the top, so you can take it out with a factor in the denominator. You cannot do that. But if you write this step and you multiply and distribute negative 1, and you multiply and then distribute negative 1, I'm fine with it. Instead of writing this, trying to avoid confusion, I perform the product before I write it. 2x times x with minus in front, 2x times 7 with minus in front, 9 times x with minus in front, 9 times 7 with minus in front. Then I reach here, x times x, x times negative 3, 5 times x, 5 times negative 3, and so on and so forth. So if you want to write this, I'm fine. I will not, however, write it. It's not wrong. It's wrong to simplify like this because it's tempting. So be aware of that. Okay, so now I'm going to jump from here to this set. And then I'll come back to this. Okay. I would like to start with the first one, A. And we have x divided by x plus 4 minus 4 divided by x minus 4 equals x squared plus 16 over x squared minus 16. Okay, ready? Now this is a totally different situation. Why is it different? Because this is not an expression, but this is an equation. So here I have to have at all times one left-hand side, one right-hand side, and at the very end I have to say x equals blah, blah, blah. Okay? Good. So I repeat the steps that we did before. By simply moving this term to the other side or the fraction to the other side, what is left on the right? Absolutely. Please write it before we even do anything, because if we forget this, we will never solve. So the first fraction stays of sx divided by x plus 4. The second fraction stays 4 as ever x minus 4 minus x squared plus 16 over okay. Anything else? Excellent, yes. Good. Now you will give me two restrictions, please. And then you will give me the least common denominator. Notice what I did. I drew the long fraction line. I wrote the equal symbol, and I wrote 0. And only now I think the least common denominator is? What does the first top, the second top, the third top need? What do they need? Wonderful. The second one needs? Wonderful. And the last one needs nothing or 1. Perfect. Now please dictate the numerator. Notice that this is not new so far, other than the fact that there is a 0 on the right hand side. X squared minus 4x. Good. Perfect. What do I do next? Good. So these two go away. Then I have negative 8x minus 16 divided by x plus 4, x minus 4 equals 0. Do you allow me to write 0 over 1? Can I write 5 as 5 over 1? Can I write 10 as 10 over 1? Can I write 0 as 0 over 1? Good. Now this becomes a proportion. Only in a proportion I'm allowed to. Thank you very much. Good. So negative 8x minus 16 times 1 must equal 0. So therefore, negative 8x equals 16. So therefore, x equals? Yes?
Question. Now, if they had negative 4, negative 4x, and then negative 16, negative 7, shouldn't that be negative 8x minus 32?
I missed that. I'm so sorry. Thank you. Thank you. Sorry. I missed that. Sorry. Good catch. It's negative 16 minus 16. I forgot to add these two. Sorry about that. Excellent. Thank you. Good catch. Good. So then x equals? Good. Now look here. What do I conclude? Thank you. Very good.
So the last that we did, we did negative 8x minus 13 equals 0. Why did you do that?
It's a proportion, and in proportion I'm allowed to cross multiply. This product equals this product. So A over B equals C over D means A times D equals B times C. Very good. Okay, next one. 12 minus 6x divided by x squared minus 4 equals 3x over x plus 2 minus 3 minus 2x over 2 minus x. I claim that one of them needs work. And of course, I will move everything to one side. So I have 12 minus 6x over what? Very good. Minus 3x over x plus 2 plus 3 minus 2x over, and I get 0 on the other side, but I have to rearrange 2 minus x, and I have to factor out negative 1.
So
so negative.
Negative in parentheses x minus 2. Very good. Do we understand this first step? Are we okay with this? Are we okay with this? Good. Now we see that there is a positive here. There is nothing else in front. Minus. So I have 12 minus 6x over x minus 2, x plus 2, minus 3x over x plus 2, and minus 3 minus 2x over x minus 2 equals 0. Do we agree with this? This one here?
Yeah.
We never look at numerators
yeah.
We add and subtract till the very final step. We state two restrictions, please. And now we find the least common denominator. Notice one thing again. I wrote a long fraction line, the equal symbol and zero, because if I forget that, I mess up the whole thing. I will never solve for anything. And now I have to find what? Yes, the LCD, x plus 2, x minus 2. Adjustments for the tops of these fractions. For the first one, what do I need? For the second one, what do I need? Very good. And for the third one, what do I need? Good. Please slowly dictate the numerator. Yes, 12 minus 6x. Then?
3x. Or minus
3x squared. Minus 3x squared. Careful.
Plus
2x. Plus 6x. Good. Then? Very good. Minus
6.
Very good. And now I have negative 2x times x, but with minus in front.
So
plus 2x squared. Very good. And then negative 2x times 2 with minus in front.
Minus 4.
Plus 4x. Combine like terms indeed. So please tell me what you get when you combine like terms. Don't forget to write the equal symbol and zero. Only one equal symbol per row. Do not try to simplify to the sides. Do not have two equal symbols in an equation. That's very important. Okay, I copy the denominator. I put 0 over 1, but I have to simplify the top. So we do have negative x squared. I agree with that. These two go away. So we took care of this and of this. So then plus x. So this and this. And then plus 6. Do you all agree with negative x squared plus x plus 6 at the top? Okay, now this becomes a proportion. Just tell me what to write. It's to multiply by 0. Negative x squared plus x plus 6 equals 0. This is a quadratic equation. Of course, I will divide both sides by negative 1 first. Because it's an equation, I don't need that factor out there. Can divide both sides by negative 1. And now I will factor this or use the quadratic formula and get the solutions. But it's easy to factor. It doesn't take more than 10 seconds. What is it? Very good. So then we have two options, x to be or good. My first concern now is back to my restrictions. So the only solution is x equals 3. A lot of steps, a lot of work, a lot. Okay, let's look at a proportion. 6 divided by 5 minus 2x equals 2. But of course I will write 2 over 1. I have to write one restriction. And then I will go ahead and cross multiply. But not before I write that one particular restriction. Move to E. Yes, and then I will do, it will do C or D, or both, and I'll let you work on those for a minute. So which restriction will you give? Very good. And then 6 equals 2 times 5 minus 2x, and you will distribute or divide both sides by 2. This is what I would do. 3 equals 5 minus 2x. I move 5. Negative 2 equals negative 2x. X equals 1. My concern is first to check against restrictions. So proportions are rational equations, but there are the simplest possible rational equations. Because I can go ahead and after I state restrictions, I cross multiply and I'm done. With all the other ones, I try to change them into a proportion by adding, subtracting those fractions, and then I get one fraction set equal to 0 over 1. I cross multiply, I'm done. Any questions on this problem? Any questions on this problem? Okay, let's do one more, and then I would like to show you the complex rational expressions. So I'll let you work on this for a minute. So let's say, C or D, you choose. You want C or you want D? Oh, okay, let's, which one? Okay, let's do D then. 1 over x minus 3 minus x minus 4 over x squared minus 9 equals 1. Okay, let's work on this for 1 minute, 2 minutes at the most. Do we need more time? Okay, can anyone tell me how to continue? I copied 1 over x minus 3. I copied minus x minus 4 over what? Very good. And I moved 1 and I have 0. You will give me 2 restrictions, right? Very good. You will give me the least common denominator. You will tell me what to multiply each top by. And here I want it multiplied because it will be easier. But you know how to factor this into this, so we cannot go back? Right, exactly. That's what it is, right? Good, so now please anyone dictate the top. That's it. Do you all agree with this step? Okay. Now these two go away. Then I have negative x squared, and this is 7 plus 9, which is 16. Isn't it? X plus 3, plus 3 is minus 3. 0 divided by 1. Now this is a proportion. We'll cross multiply. Negative x squared plus 16 equals 0. I have several methods now. I know this is quadratic, and I would like to do this. Divide both sides by negative 1. Which method of those four do you think I'm getting ready to apply here? Of course. Of course. So then x equals plus or minus 4. It's not among the restrictions? Yes. Now, I would like to show an example from the complex rational expressions and an example from the literal equations, which you will have no difficulties with. And then if we have time, I know I have roughly 10 minutes or so, and then we can go back to anything else you want. And this is the end of new material. We're done. Yes. Okay, so I'm going to look at B. Please just watch and then I'll let you copy. I'll give you time to copy and then we'll look at another one if you want. Okay. This is so-called complex rational expression in the sense that it kind of sounds like difficult. Well, this is the issue here. At the top, I have operations with fractions. In the denominator, I have operations with fractions. That's the difficult part. But if I remember how to find the least common denominator for the top and the least common denominator for the denominator, I'll be okay. Shouldn't be any problem. Can anyone dictate the least common denominator here? So one denominator is 1, the other one is x, and the last one is x squared. So the least common denominator must be x squared because I have to have answers to 3 questions. What does this need? Good. What does this need? And what does this need? Perfect. So then I have x squared plus 3x minus 18. And I performed the operations. I added, subtracted the fractions from the top, and I'm done with the top. Now I'm looking at the least common denominator for the denominator. Assuming that you don't even have this, just please tell me what is the least common denominator here? Right. So this one, and this one. What does this one need? 1. This one, and this one. That's it. So then I have 21 minus 4x minus x squared. Of course, I will write that x cannot be 0. And now I'm asking myself, okay, I have a fraction at the top. I have a fraction at the bottom. How do I divide 2 fractions? I have to copy the top and multiply it by the reciprocal of the bottom. Good. I'd like to not to waste time and writing, I like to factor that. I have to factor it. If it's factorable, of course. Can I factor this? How? X. Very good. Now, with this, I have difficulty because it's not arranged in descending order. So I'll keep it like this first. And then I will see what I can do. At this stage, this is a product. I will definitely do this. I don't want to write that quantity again. Furthermore, I already stated restrictions for it. So then the top with the minus in front, the top is x plus 6, x minus 3. Now I have to factor a denominator and put it here. Yes? Very good. Now for this, I have to add two restrictions to the list. X cannot be negative 7, it cannot be 3. Now I'm ready to get rid of factors if common factors are at the top and the bottom. Very good. Don't forget to write 1 and 1. So what is the simplified form of this so-called complex rational expression? Assuming these restrictions are fulfilled. And that's it. Once you know how to add and subtract, and you get the top into one fraction and the bottom into one fraction, you will flip the bottom and you're done. Okay, I want you to choose one literal equation from number 9, and then we'll do whatever you want till the end of the class. Okay, I'm going to choose C, and then you could choose the next one. So A equals P plus P RT. We want to solve for P. So what will you tell me to do?
Solve P?
Yes.
So you
subtract
P
RT? No.
Subtract A by R.
I can't? No. I thought you said it first.
He said subtract P, but he said
we can't. I can't. If I have x and x and I move this x to the other side, I will not solve for x.
If you divide,
I can't. What is the key word in algebra? What am I factoring? Exactly. You'd better give me two terms now. Nope. Those are not two terms. I need two terms. Nope. Yes. Right, because P times 1 is P, and P times RT is PRT. So finally, P is how much? I'm solving for P. What do I have to do to both sides to solve for P? Right, of course I have to divide. 1 plus RT. Very good. Please choose another. Remember always, factor, simplify are keywords in algebra. Factor, simplify, factor, simplify. Good. Okay, let's choose one more. D is in dog, right? Okay, very good. 1 divided by R equals 1 divided by A plus 1 divided by B. We're asked to solve for A. In this particular situation, I'm not trying to change the rules on you, but in this particular situation, if I move everything to one side and find the least common denominator, that will be more difficult because of these two, which are not the same with A. Here, I did that because I only had one variable. But here, I have basically three variables, but I'm only solving for one. So I'm only going to move to the other side just this. So the new equation becomes 1 over R minus 1 over B equals 1 over A. Leave 1 over A alone and find the least common denominator and combine the left-hand side.
R, B, R minus B.
RB is the least common denominator, correct? And now the adjustments for the top. What does the first one need?
B.
B, indeed. What does the second one need? R. So what do you get at the top? Indeed. Now I will cross multiply to solve for A. Do not distribute. Just write A parentheses B minus R equals RB. And now you tell me what to do for the final step. Exactly. Here's what I would have done from here. I just want to show you a minor little, I should say, little trick. You can do this. As long as you swap both at the same time, and you get A equals RB over B minus R. I know it was a lot. We finished the entire chapter. Monday, I would like to review everything, all chapter 7 again. We'll have problems from each chapter.